Hello, hello, and welcome to my channel. My name is Emily, and this is my channel, Books for Life. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, but you like my content, please make sure you hit that like button and subscribe down below. Today, I'm here for my March TBR. I am going to participate in my second readathon of the year. I'm doing so well already. I'm really proud. So I have decided that I am going to participate in March Mystery Madness again. I participated last year, and I really found that this was a great way to get some of my mystery books off my shelves. Now, they do have prompts, but they all have to do with the number 5 because this is the 5th year, which is really cool that they're doing that, but I don't have any books that fit it, and I just really want to read my mystery books, and I don't want to have to go to the library and find other books. I want to read the ones that are already on my shelves, and they did say that you can read any mystery books you want. So I will leave the information down below. With this, I'm also going to kind of participate in middle grade March. 2 of the mystery books that I have chosen are middle grade books. I think the goal is to read at least 2 middle grade books. I'm not positive on that, so I will leave information down below in the description box about that readathon as well if you are interested in participating. So my goal is to read at least 5 mystery books. I am hoping I will read maybe 7, but I want to read at least 5. So the first book that I know I will read during the month of March is actually a buddy read, and I am going to be buddy reading with Lacey D. Bell. I will leave her channel link down below. I am so excited to buddy read with her. I've been hoping to be able to buddy read with her for a while now, and so we have decided to buddy read Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. And so this is a book of the month book, so this also checks off my book from a book box that I was hoping to get, although I have other book box books I'm going to be reading too this month. But this is a mystery book. You follow this main character whose name is Alex, and she ends up dropping out of school. By the age of 20, she has had crazy life experiences, and one of them is being the only survivor of a multiple homicide. Alex is given the opportunity to attend Yale. However, she must figure out the secrets of the different societies that are involved in like Yale's campus. So she needs to figure out like what they're doing and how they are doing it. And I think that is the mystery piece of this. Like, this is a psychological mystery thriller, I believe. Like, trying to figure out like what they're doing, and I believe, like, maybe I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that this is, it says it's a tale of power, privilege, dark magic, and murder. Sounds mysterious to me. So I am excited to get to this. This has been extremely hyped the last couple months. A lot of people are talking about it, and I'm excited to join in and figure out what is really going on in this book. One of my goals for 2020 is to read more books from my classroom library, and I have a middle grade book that fits this perfectly. This book is Took by Mary Downing Hahn. So this was on my 12 books that I want to read in my classroom from my classroom library. I will leave a link to that up above. And this is a ghost story. You follow Daniel and his sister, and they move to West Virginia, and neither of them wanted to move to begin with. They are not really accepted at the new school. They are treated as outsiders, and people view them as snobby. But they hear stories about this old witch. Erica ends up becoming very withdrawn, and she ends up only really having conversations with her doll, and then she goes missing. And Daniel knows it is up to him to figure out who has taken his sister and how to get her back. This is less than 300 pages. I really enjoyed Mary Downing Hahn when I was in middle school. Like, I remember Andrew's Ghost and Helen's Ghost, I think, and A Time for Andrew. I'll leave like pictures here, but I remember reading those when I was in middle school and late elementary and really enjoying. So I'm excited to get back into Mary Downing Hahn's writing and check one of those 12 books off my list because I haven't read one yet. The next book is a middle grade book, and this is Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson. So this is a book that I had on my series to read during 2020, and this is a middle grade book, and this is about this school. It's a private academy, and when the school was built, the founder's wife and daughter are kidnapped, and the only thing that's left behind is a riddle, and it is signed with the pseudonym Truly Devious. No one has been able to solve this mystery. No one knows what happened to them or where they went. Then we have Stevie Bell, and she is attending the school and has decided that she is going to crack this cold case. So we follow her as she tries to figure out what happened to the founder's wife and daughter. I've heard this is fantastic. I have the sequel. If I can get to the sequel as well, I will try to read that one too. But I'm going to read this as my second middle grade book and my third mystery book for the month. All right, so now what I have left are 3 Book of the Month books, and they are all suspense, psychological thriller, mystery books. So I have The Child by Fiona Barton, The Dark Lake by Sarah Bailey, and A Nearly Normal Family by M.T. Edverson. And I do not know which ones I am going to read of these. My plan, though, is to read two of them. I'm not sure which, but as a very quick synopsis, A Nearly Normal Family is about this family where the daughter, the teenage daughter, Stevie, is accused of murdering a man who is 15 years older than she is. This psychological thriller makes you ask a lot of questions like, how well do you know your family? How far would you go to protect your loved ones? Can you ever really know somebody else? People thought she was just an ordinary teenager and that she didn't even know this man, but now she is accused of this crime. Stella's father, did I say Stevie earlier? I meant to say Stella. Stella's father is a pastor and her mother is a lawyer, and they need to figure out their own like moral compass and how they can defend their daughter whilst trying to even figure out how she could even be accused of such a horrendous crime with a man that she should never have even known. So I am really leaning toward this one. I think I purchased this in the summer. Yeah, June 2019. So this is the newest one that I have out of these two, but I'll quickly tell you what these two are about as well. So this is about a sergeant who happens to find a strangled woman in the lake. And this isn't just any woman, but this is the beautiful Rose. And she was really popular in high school, and now that she has returned back to the school to teach, she is another favorite. And the town is really shook up by what happened. They're trying to figure out what happened to her. Why did she leave her old teaching job to take one in her hometown when her father was really rich and owns buildings? Why is she living in a rundown apartment? Does anyone really know who she is and what could have happened to her? And so you follow this sergeant. They were together in school, and so you follow them as the sergeant is trying to figure out what happened to her. This one I have had since October 2017, and this one I've had since July 2017. So it would be really great to get both of them off my shelves, although this does not sound nearly as good as A Nearly Normal Family. I think this is definitely gonna be, I'm really leaning toward this one. So the last one I have to talk to you about is The Child by Fiona Barton. So they are demolishing a building, and as they are demolishing it, they find a tiny skeleton, and they realized that there was a baby buried where this building is. So for Kate Waters, this sparks in her need to know what happened. She wants to figure out what happened to this baby. Why was this child left behind? Whose was it? And she keeps asking the question, who is the building site baby? And as she goes on this investigation, she discovers that there was a crime committed years ago when a baby was stolen from a maternity ward. And she's wondering if this has anything to do with that. And so she begins to unearth some clues to figure out why this baby was left here. If you've read any of these books and you think that I should pick one or the other of them, please let me know in the comments below. I'm really leaning toward this one, but I'm not sure which of these, or maybe I'll surprise myself and read just these two, or maybe I'll read all three. But if you've read them and you know I should pick up one of these, let me know in the comments down below. Okay, so I'm really sorry for that background noise if you can hear it. It sounds like someone's generator is going off, but I just left the library and I found three more books that I want to read during the month of March. And I know that I like literally just filmed my March TBR maybe like 4 hours ago, but I'm already like going to modify it. So I'm not taking any books away. I'm just going to challenge myself to read even more. So I had originally told you that my plan was to read 5 mystery, scary, psychological thriller type of books for March Mystery Madness. Well, my library, I put on hold this book, and they actually had to get it from another library and it just came here. So I have The Whisper Man now by Alex North, and everybody talks about how scary this is, and I'm kind of really scared to read it. Like, what if it gives me nightmares? I don't know, but
I want to read it. So it's about this father and son, Tom Kennedy and his son Jake, and his wife dies. And so they move to a new town named Featherbank. But 20 years ago, a serial killer abducted and murdered 5 people. And then Frank Carter was finally caught, and he was nicknamed the Whisper Man because he lured his victims out by whispering at their windows. So Tom and Jake have settled into the new home, but then a young boy disappears. And it sounds just like Frank Carter's crimes. And then Jake begins hearing whispering. Ah! So this year, I'm like on a huge Criminal Minds binge right now. Like since October, I'm on, I think, season 11. And there's like 24 episodes in every season. It's really a problem in my life. And this sounds just like that. And I'm really excited for it. Okay, and since it's also middle grade March, I have always wanted to read The One and Only Ivan by Catherine Applegate. I've heard it's amazing. I know it's about like this gorilla at a zoo. I did not know that it was verse though. So I could probably hammer this book out in a couple hours and I'm like, okay, I can do it. I can read this book too. It's about a gorilla at a zoo. And he watches humans. That's what I know. And I'm excited. Okay, one more, I promise, and that's it. So I also got The Girl Who Drank the Moon by Kelly Barnhill. And I've heard really good things about this one too. It's about this town where they think they have to like sacrifice a baby to this witch, like the witch of the forest or whatever. And this witch is actually really kind, and so when they sacrifice babies, she like picks them up and carries them through the forest, feeding them off starlight, and then brings them to the other side to another village where then she finds like a loving home for them. But the people of the village want to kill the witch because they think that she's taking their babies, but she's not. So it sounds really good. It does kind of have like a mystery element to it. I'm excited for it. I've heard great things. So yeah, so I've decided to add 3 more books to my TBR. Hopefully I'll do well. All right, I'm gonna let old me end this video. Okay, bye. So here are my mystery and middle grade books for the month of March. What are you planning on reading? Are you participating in any readathons? Let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give this a thumbs up and hit subscribe. And I'll be back for a bookish video soon. As always, keep reading.